Ted Greenfield, over 50 and learning to fly, and today we've got a little bit of a different program for you. We're going to answer your questions on a subject that I've been getting a lot of questions about, and that's aircraft insurance. What are the premiums? What's covered? How do you navigate it? And is it expensive? Today we're going to answer all these questions for you on Over 50 and Learning to Fly. How much is this going to cost to insure? What do I do if I get into an accident? Has this happened to you? What are the insurance premiums? What about the other guy? Does this happen to him? How much is it going to cost to insure my plane? What's going on? Who knows?
This subject should not be a mystery. And the last thing this subject should do is stop anybody from buying an airplane. Let's start off by saying if you own an airplane, you must have insurance. And if you are renting, you also must have insurance. But it's not that complicated. So let's jump in and talk about the five things you should know about aircraft owner's insurance. Number one, it can be about the same as your car insurance. Yes, my first policy was $790 a year. My car insurance on my 2015 VW Jetta with 88,000 miles on it was $840 a year. Yeah, my airplane insurance was cheaper. Now, I did this when I had about 280 hours and just a private pilot rating. Your rates will decrease with additional ratings. Here is something you should know about this, and this was a surprise to me. A few days after I had earned my instrument rating, I called my insurance company and I said, "Hey, I'm awesome, and now I've got my instrument rating. What's my new rate?" And they said, "It will be calculated next year when my policy renews." And I was a bit surprised by that. So I didn't go to another company or anything. I decided to wait. When my policy renews in August, then I'll get what my new rate is. And I should have my multi and commercial by then, so all the better. Number two, hull coverage. Hull coverage is hull coverage and it does not include upgrades. I paid $38,000 for my airplane and it had barely functioning instruments in it and I upgraded everything. Afterwards, I increased my hull coverage up to $55,000 to cover the upgrades. Now, my annual premium is now at about $1,100 to $1,200 a year. And if you buy an older aircraft and you plan to upgrade, you'll get a nice insurance rate at the beginning, which is nice. But as you upgrade, don't forget to increase your policy coverage to cover your upgrades. I don't want to have the money I spent on upgrades be lost if something should happen. Number three, insurance companies are quite competitive and you will get different quotes. I'm not going to endorse one company over another unless they pay me, but I was pretty surprised when I called another company after I saw their internet ad and they were significantly higher even out of the gate, even with my instrument rating. So I decided to stay with the company I'm with now. All this being said, shop around and it pays. Remember, insurance companies want your business, so make them work for it. You will find after a few phone calls, you can get the number you work with. Number four, this was really cool. You can add people to your policy. So listen to this. I hate for things to sit there and not be used. And if it were up to me, I would be flying every day. But for now, I still have to work. So from September till now, my plane sat during the winter weekdays, and I spent a lot of time in Florida over this winter. And I really could only fly during the weekend because I had a lot going on. So I brought the plane down to Florida with me, and I flew it during the weekends. So I let some friends who needed hours use my plane, just so number one, the plane would be used, and number two, I can help them out, because if you give, you get. So I added them onto the policy. There are two ways you can do this. Number one, there is what's called an open pilot policy. And with my insurance company, if a pilot has more than 10 hours in the type of aircraft, they were covered in my airplane. And then number two is you can just add a person on. I added a friend of mine on for $300 for the year who needed to get her hours up. And a happy plane is a plane that is flying. I wasn't really too concerned about the hours that were being added onto my airplane because they were not going to be flying 200 or 300 hours. We're talking maybe 50 to 80 at the most, and I don't even think it's going to be anywhere near there. I'm a big believer in give and it will be given to you, and it pays to be generous, and I just don't want my plane sitting there. Number 5, do not let this subject stop you. Aircraft insurance is not that expensive, and it's not a deal breaker, but not having aircraft insurance is. I got an email from a viewer who was very concerned about this, and I asked him, who did you call? He said he didn't, and I wanted to scream. Don't let something you don't know the answer to stop you. Get out there, get on the phone, and get a quote. You'll be pleasantly surprised that aircraft insurance is not that big of a mystery, and it's not that expensive. So, get out there, get on the phone, you'll be in the air in no time. So, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, subscribe to the channel, it helps, and stay tuned because I'm about to do the most awesome rating ever, and you are going to be coming with me. Thanks, we'll see you soon.